GIS by its nature is sort of interdisciplinary. And so we have students not only in geography, but in environmental sciences and economics and historic preservation. And we're teaching how to use the technology in different ways. And so rather than use sort of the canned data that comes out, I do show them how to use the raw data and how the raw data is then developed into data that is more manageable. So we go through the Tiger files, I explain Tiger data and why it was created, when it was created. I give them a little bit of a history there. My students have to do a final project at the end of the year, and every week I remind them that they need to start collecting data. And I'd say probably 80% of those students use census data to augment the data that they're working with, so they can actually relate this to the population density or some economic factor.
SRLN is designed to connect allied professionals to help improve access to justice and access to our civil courts, making them more approachable and easier for people to get the resources they need. We got to tell the story of the Florida Bar Foundation and how civil legal aid is a crucial second responder after natural disasters. Hurricane Irma swept through Florida, and everybody knows of the first responders that helps get people food and shelter immediately, but what civil legal aid does is it helps people rebuild their lives, get their documents that they need, sign up for benefits, and put the pieces back together again. We use the Census Bureau data to help identify the areas that were most legally vulnerable, meaning those people might not have reached out for help from civil legal aid organizations. We took each county within Florida and we used proportional symbols that show the number of people that were certain risk factors. And then we showed each of those risk factors independently so they could start to see the areas that had the most number of people that needed help. It's a way to be impartial and just report count. And then we aggregated all of those things and created a legal vulnerability index so that the Florida Bar Foundation was able to ensure that they gave grants to the organization that serves those areas.
Currently, I am working on a project with the Fire EMS Department where we are trying to assess and ultimately reduce fire risks in the community. I'm gathering data from various sources. Some things we have in-house, others are from the state. I'm also getting some census data. For example, structure size. A larger house means more of a fire risk. Age is very young children, and having elderly people can increase the fire risk. I'm gathering all this data, and then ultimately we're going to assign or assess a risk value to each single family home in the county. That data will ultimately be used to help determine where to put some more resources.
Venture Philanthropy Partners, or VPP for short, is a grant-making organization here in the District of Columbia that predominantly serves youth and young adults throughout the greater Washington, D.C. area. We identify the particular areas, either geographic areas or areas of need, using a variety of census products, predominantly census data itself, but increasingly the American Community Survey, the ACS. For example, if we are really focused on identifying where we can provide the greatest amount of support and services to little ones, to ages 0 to 2 years old, we have to know where the largest proportion of those kids are in the community, but also look at additional complementary data, like how many of those are already in early learning supports and services, and which of the communities in our catchment area really have a dearth of those services. Another example of how VPP makes investments using data is really focusing on the composition of households and what we think a particular intervention might need based on households at the census tract level or the census block group level. The census data products really allow us to paint that picture of what's going on at sort of the community and the neighborhood level, so that when we as a funding entity support nonprofit providers and community groups in these geographic locations, we can provide them with assistance.
I was very surprised in school at seeing how much data was accessible to us as students and us as researchers. In my intro to GIS course, we use census data to track different racial inequalities in certain cities and neighborhoods. We also use census data to track wealth inequalities and disparities between different urban and suburban areas. One of my big projects that I did for my spatial analysis course was I tracked the 5 boroughs of New York, and I tracked white flight from 2000 to 2010, and I used census data by looking at white-owned homes in comparison to other minorities and people of color's homes, and I tracked them down by income and school to see like if there was a correlation between if someone was a recent graduate or if someone was not a recent graduate, if they were a homeowner, and if that changed over time. And using census data to track that and manage that and make that stuff navigable is important and imperative to defining that type of research.
We've been working with census data for a long time, so we're very accustomed to working with it. We work closely with them to understand the formats of the data, how to incorporate it into our data sets, and going back 25 years actually to the origination of the Tiger data. And we have a product called US Topo, which is kind of our next generation US topographic map. And we also have a variety of different other products, such as the National Map Viewer. And topographic maps comprise a lot of different data sets, including several that we work closely with Census Bureau to incorporate into our products. So we're remapping the United States every 3 years. So that's where our relationship with Census is critical, because it's very important for us to keep the data current. And especially when working with transportation data, it changes a lot. We're also continually improving those products. And we've actually been working for the last 3 years extensively with Census to improve the quality of the transportation data sets.